internet. Darkly Dave here, and today I will be teaching you how to make some Halloween cookies. Specifically bat-shaped ones, of course. Now, for this recipe, you'll need a mixing bowl, an electric beater, 125 grams of butter, which it's best to put in the microwave in a bowl for about 30 seconds, just to soften it up and make it easy to cream together with the sugars, for which you will need half a cup of brown sugar, a third of a cup of caster sugar, 1 teaspoon of vanilla essence, 1 egg, 1.5 cups of self-raising flour, and 1/3 cup of cocoa powder. If you want, and you're not using a cookie cutter, 3/4 cup of dark chocolate chips can also be added to make chocolate chip cookies. Now, the first stage is to preheat your oven to 160 degrees Celsius. Sorry, I don't know what that is in Fahrenheit. And your first stage for the recipe is to cream your sugars with your butters, which will make a nice crunchy base for your recipe. Oh, that's a delightful sound, isn't it? Start your beater off on a low speed. Otherwise, you end up spraying sugary butter everywhere. Now ensure that the butter is properly stirred in with sugar. Otherwise, it will give you grief later in the recipe. Doesn't take very long, and you'll end up with a nice creamy sort of texture. Next, add your egg. Being careful not to get any shell in the recipe, and then add teaspoon vanilla essence. Very careful not to add too much of this stuff, otherwise it will be to the great detriment of your baking. Again, on a low speed, I will spray stuff everywhere. Then add flour and cocoa powder, sift it in, otherwise you'll end up with big clumps. And in this stage, it's probably not advisable to be wearing black, but I live in it, so what are you going to do? Add your cocoa. Now, it's best to get a good quality cooking cocoa. You can use the drinking stuff, it's all pretty much the same thing. Just ensure that it is good quality. It might be an idea to try and mix it through a second. Just to make it a bit easier. And in a low setting, start it crumbing together. Of course, you're going to need to turn it up as the mixture gets thicker. And you'll notice that it starts to crumb together rather nicely. Make sure that it's mixed thoroughly together, otherwise you'll end up with floury spots. And you may need to let the mixture come away from the beaker occasionally. Otherwise, you'll just end up with one big gluey mess. Also something worth noting, if you have it in the cupboard, don't mess up and put coffee sugar instead of brown sugar, otherwise you'll end up with nicely crunchy biscuits, but they'll end up with big sugary bits in the middle of it all. Now, using regular non-self-raising flour, just add a small amount to your work surface. Doesn't stick, otherwise you'll never get your biscuits off. Put a small amount of flour over that as well, just to keep things nice and non-stick. Then get your cookie dough out. It is very thick mix, but it sticks fairly well to itself, which is nice. And then you're going to just gently push the mix out. Now, if you're doing this in winter and you have the fire on, it will be a little bit harder because the mix will try to stick to pretty much everything and make a terrible mess. Now roll it out till it's about 5 millimeters thick. Ensuring to keep your rolling pin in just that little bit of flour. It also helps to do it with the cookie cutter. Then get your tray and cut out the cookies. I'll fast forward this bit. think. Skip straight ahead. You can see the finished product. Now, as you go through, you will need to re-roll and re-roll again as you run out of biscuit mix. Well, I'll see you after I finish. And there you are. Nice little Halloween bats. Generally the recipe makes about 30 of them and it takes between 10 and 15 minutes to make. They only take about 15 minutes to cook at 160 degrees as well. So make sure you keep an eye on them. If you burn them, they'll still taste fine. They won't look as good. And it tastes absolutely fantastic with coffee. Now, I'm also going to show you how to make a variant of this recipe for making coffee-flavored black. Lovely little biscuits. Get your nuked butter. Sugars first. Half a cup brown. Third caster. Butter. And beef. Now, I'm also going to show you how to make a variant of this recipe for making coffee-flavored black. Lovely little biscuits. Your nuked butter. Add your egg. Sugars first. Half a cup brown. Third caster. Butter. And beat. And there we are. Some more lovely Halloween cookies. Now, if you like this video, click subscribe below to see what other videos I have in my channel, and also for you to be notified when I make some more. And you can also hit like if you want, that would be much appreciated. I also have links below to Twitter and Tumblr. And thank you very much for watching. I hope you too enjoy some Halloween time. I know I will. Thank you.